Hello, comic book fans. Here's Earl Grey. Today I want to talk about the gallery edition of Kelly Jones' Batman. It's the arc after Batman reappeared after the Bane accident, and Kelly Jones had an exorbitant different take on the Batman outward appearance and the myth that Batman is. For comparison, I have here this hardcover trade from the same arc, some stories that are here, collected here, aren't in the gallery edition, but most of them are. So, let's see. It's a huge book. You may guess from seeing my hand here. And beautiful one, too, as well. So we open it up. And you see what which issues here are collected. In this oversized artist edition, sort of presenting them from 515 to 525, we have, yeah, it's pretty jam-packed with stories. So let's look, take a deeper look into this book. They have these frontispieces things between before each cover, so that you can look at the cover picture image with or without the title. That's a neat trick. So, and of course, like in all artist edition, you get a closer glimpse at the way the stuff is done. So, for example, it looks like this Batman is cut out of a different paper and glued on the back with this black spraying, and some painting of these lines is going on here. There are few pencils showing here. That's a bit a pity, but the inking from John Beattie is very interesting too, and these pages really shine in this black and white format. So I actually don't have anything to argue against that. The first issue is a bit in. Due to the post Gorbachev era, I think these stories are from the 90s. So here we have some Russian villains or villains of Russian origins, like Romana and KGB Beast from the KGB, KGB, and one Cossack, the Dark, AKA the Dark Rider. So that's an interesting take on possible villains in Gotham. But it's just one issue, at least that's contained here, and it is concluded somewhere else here in Shadow of the Bat, 34 Vega. Yeah. Okay, moving on. This is issue 516 with this iconic cover that's used for the cover of the collection. And Here you see something that struck me really right from the beginning with these stories, the similarity to Sandman. Kelly Jones, both in the look that these stories have and in the storytelling as well. Kelly Jones had his breakthrough with Sandman. The Season of Mists was penciled for a good part by Kelly Jones. And here you see art that could served really good in the Sandman stories as well. And if you see here the story Sleeper, Part 1, Nightmares, it's about one girl that is held back from sleep, and the sleep deprivation let her become a mass murderer. So it's a bit a negative copy of the Sandman stories. And you have, I think I read to some of this eternal waking trope that was very prominent in the Sandman stories. And this pops up here at a certain point too, even though these stories didn't weren't drawn by Kelly Jones. So, written is the whole stuff by Dark Monk, and he and Jones really bring Batman to his darkest edge, even sometimes close to the edge of a caricature. If you look at this grim face, and he's posing very often in this way in here. It's definitely not a realistic take on Batman, but a take on Batman that experiments with the means of stylization, like, for an example, Tim Sale did. But Tim Sale has a bit more this decorative approach to Batman. Tim Sale's panels manage often to get really beautiful, and Kelly Jones isn't so much for the beauty, but all for the experimentation, and I'm very fine with this approach. Every page has something unique to it, an idea of a graphic sorts or storytelling wise, and sometimes each panel has an astonishing perspective or trick or something to admire, and that's really neat, and more so if you can look at the source material that I'm showing you here. Yeah, here Batman crouching on a windowsill with these old-fashioned earphones. Yeah, technical, it's more the older Batman with this old Batmobile here. The tech things here are, even for the 90s, look a bit aged, but very interesting. There you go with the Batmobile. So, let's see. Ah, yeah, here, Nightmares. Out of sleep deprivation, drawn and inked by Jones and Beatty in a very impressive manner. Almost a bit Art Deco this swirls and patterns and decorative feel. Lift this book a bit. Nice, huh? The original art wasn't found for each page, and where they haven't no original art, they reprinted the production stats. I think that are some copies done for editorial purposes. So here you see some corrections for this woman, where Jones glued some paper on her face to make some make her more beautiful, younger looking. So second longer story arc is about this villain here, Black Mask. And really a bit old Golden Age character of sorts here. And there's this guy, Black Spider too, but I want to show you here. Page sized panel. Here you have the colored version of the pages I've just shown you. And here's the colored version of this page here. You see, it's very, everything is very well planned. How the page should look in the colored version. So, it's gone. Let's see. So, talking about colors. This page, where Batman has to deal with the Black Spider, is a good example for two things. One, the black and white page looks amazing. Two, it is a bit harder to get the necessary information out of it in comparison to the colored version, where you see, okay, Batman is obviously drunk. Drown in this fluid, and this fluid doesn't look too healthy. And yeah, but again, as I usually say, this coloring is a bit too polished for me, and I really like this harder edge, if you want to call it so, version with the black and white stuff here. Especially when you have this more areas with black. And since we're talking about a Batman comic, there is much black in it. Okay, this page here, this front cover from Batman 521, is really neat because you see it on the colored version that this image has at least three levels. You have Killer Croc in the foreground that was summoned in the story by a Swamp Thing. And in the middle ground you have Batman with a very grim face. Almost Tim Sale-like teeth. I think there are some similarities between both of these artists. And in the back, you have some bats. And they reprinted these levels on separate pages, on transparent paper. So you can look at each level for itself, and you can look at all these levels all together, this cover. That's a nice idea, I think. Makes it clear how much effort and work was done, was put into this cover image. This is a variant cover from the issue before that was put right into this place here, and here you have Killer Croc colored version I've showed you just a second before. So this Swamp Thing Killer Croc story is really neat too, most and foremost because of splendid art that it's going on here. Really interesting for me are these original color guide pages with the watercolor coloring from Gregory Wright, the colorist of these stories. And in comparison to the final colored version, they are a bit paler most of the time, but I like them more because they have these irregularities. They are more interesting to look at, to put it shortly. There's more to look at, and I really do like colors more that were made by a colorist than by a computer. I hope you get what I mean, yeah? So, nice color guide pages, and here it goes on with this glorious black and white. And of course, Batman's cape is as exaggerated as hell. There's nothing functional to a cape like this one, but it looks amazing. And this Batman is, as I said it before, more on the stylized side of things than anything. So here we have a beautiful black and white page. Yeah, some plants in outline shapes, and here you have the colored version of this cover. And the meeting of Killer Croc, Batman, and the Swamp Thing in the swamp is one of the highlights in this gallery edition. For me, especially, there's a double page spread somewhere here. Yeah. Isn't that neat? Well, if I could choose one page out of this book that I would like an original art, if I would be rich someday, and this page would be available, I definitely would try my best to get my fingers on this one. Look at these turtles on the knee of the monster here. Swampy. Neat. Neat, neat, neat. So, what do we do? So, what we have else in store here? A scarecrow story. Of course, we have a good amount of classic Batman villains appearing in the story arcs here. Ah yeah, here's something else I want to show you, because this isn't just this panel where Batman hangs above this panel, like in an old theater. It's almost as if he holds the curtain up before the stage. And somehow this is how these stories feel, a bit like an expressionistic drama done in a bit old-fashioned way and over-the-top exaggerated way. And it's very typical that Jones tries this way to make his point. So, to play with different panels here, and very impressive expressionistic cover with scarecrow pictures in the background, and again a color guide. And this page with the color guide I found more interesting, because even more interesting than the others, because here you have the advisory how to mix the colors. Yeah. How many yellow, blue, and red here should be used for this colors. Yeah, you have the comparison to the a computerized version of this coloring, and maybe it's that I'm an older guy and can't deal too much with these bright colors that hurt my old eyes, but I like this pale matte coloring a bit more, and with these irregularities that comes from yeah, a human painting and not so much a computer program doing the stuff the colorist tells him to do, of course. So it's very neat to compare these things. And again, you have this Batman over on the top, a bit like a frame figure, pulling the curtains from the drama that unfolds for our eyes. Beautiful black and white art. Maybe I can let you give a closer look of these really bold black and white takes on Batman. Yeah, decorative as hell. And if you like Tim Sale and would like to see an artist doing a bit even more exaggerated stylistic approach on Batman, the stories here, Kelly Jones stories, are really a good way to go. If not for this gallery edition, you may want to take the colored this trade here, the trade paperback with the colored stories. There you get even more stories from Batman. So I lost a bit track here. I think it comes. Mr. Freeze has an appearance too. Not necessary to mention that he looks impressive like all the other characters that appear here in this gallery edition. And because this gallery edition is jam-packed to the brim with issues, stories, there is no bonus section with bonus art in the back. But I think if you have such a thick, huge book, even for the exorbitant prices, I have to admit, there's nothing to argue with this offering here from DC in cooperation with Graffiti Design. So that's for now. Thanks for listening and watching. Goodbye.